my lovely students, good afternoon. Hope so you are fine and taking due care of yourself. My dear students, welcome to World of Chemistry and welcome to digital classes. It is your chemistry period and we are doing chapter 2, Is Matter Around Us Pure? And today's topic is heterogeneous solution and its types. My dear students, as already we have done the previous topics of this chapter, hope so you understood. If still you are facing some problem, you are it is my request that you are going to watch those all videos which I have uploaded in WhatsApp and in my YouTube channel also. You can ask me freely, okay, if any help you want. So let's start with the positive mindset. The thought of the day is, teachers open the door, but you must enter by yourself. It is very important proverb. Teachers are always ready to teach you, always ready to help you, always ready to counsel you. But it's you people, you must enter, you must ask question, you must come forward during this pandemic situation to study and to just improve your education standard. So it's my request, dear students, especially to those students who are not taking these digital classes seriously. You mean come out from your box and come to stand with the school and just study through these online classes, okay? So let's start recapitulation. What is the matter? It's classification that we did. You know very well, physically solid, liquid, gases are the classification, and chemically homogeneous and heterogeneous is the solution. In which homogeneous, already we did true solution, we did its properties, we did the basic activities related to solution. Now today we are going to start heterogeneous. So without wasting any time, start heterogeneous solution. So classification is there again. Again we are going to revise the same thing. Matter is classified into pure and mixture, and pure is classified into element compound, mixture is classified into homogeneous, heterogeneous, okay? So what is basic difference between homo and hetero? Homo means same, uniform. Hetero means different. So homo is those mixture in which substances are completely mixed together and uniform in composition, whereas heterogeneous is there those substances which remain separated and particles are uniformly distributed. Suppose scientifically, if we will say the mixture is pure and matter is pure and mixture, whereas mixture is uniform, homogeneous, heterogeneous, whereas homogeneous is true solution and heterogeneous is colloids and suspension. So today we are going to start heterogeneous. Basically two type of heterogeneous is there, collider solution and suspension. So let's understand, dear students, what is collider solution. A solution is a heterogeneous mixture of two or more substance. For example, mixture of starch in water, mixture of egg, albumin in water, milk, and containing dust of smoke. Properties, if we'll talk, collider solution is a heterogeneous mixture. The particles cannot be seen by naked eye. The solute particle cannot be separated by filtration. The solute particle do not settle down and the solution is stable. The particles scatter a beam of light passing through it and the path of light is visible in the solution. Okay, so these are the properties. You can go through properties of solution also and then differentiate. Understand the collides with different method. It is a type of mixture in which one substance is dispersed evenly throughout another. A collider system consists of two separate phase, a dispersed phase and dispersion phase. Okay, it means that collides are always showing the scattering of light due to this dispersion phase and disperse phase. Many families substances are colloids as shown in the chart below, as well as there is natural occurring colloids. Modern, suppose some colloids are translucent because of the Tyndall effect, which is scattering the light by particle of colloids. Other colloids may be opaque. Some example, black tea, ink color, and you can say the shake, banana, or any juice. Okay, these are colloids particle. One property of collider system that distinguishes from other solution is collider particles scatter light, whereas solution is not scattering light. If a beam of light pass through the colloids, the light is reflecting by colloidal particles and the path of the light can be observed. A colloid is heterogeneous mixture. The size of particle of colloid is too small to be individual seen by naked eye. Colloidal do not settle down when left and undisturbed. Okay. There are different types of colloids. Suppose aerosol. Aerosol is the colloids mixture of gas and liquid. For example, fog is there in your surrounding. Foam, that shaving foam also you can say, liquid in gas, which is wiped cream. Emulsion, now it is my request, by thinking all these example, you just have to pick one and you will explain that one small one example of one type of colloids. Like you can take example of aerosol, you can take example of foam, you can take make emulsion at home with different liquid and milk. Suppose milk, you mix with milk with some other chocolate, then you show the emulsion. Sol, that is liquid in solid, it is a paint, mixture of two paint, that is also example. Solid foam, solid emulsion, solid sol, these are some example. So it is my request now, dear students, you will mix by your own whatever things is there at your home. Then you will make 1 minute video and explain the different properties of colloid, show the scattering of light, and then send it to me on my WhatsApp. Okay, so second type of colloidal heterogeneous is suspension. Now what is difference between suspension and colloid? That is important. A suspension is heterogeneous mixture of two or more substances. Just for example, sand in water, chalk powder in water. Chalk powder in water is also very common. Suspension is a heterogeneous mixture. It is the particle can be seen in naked eye. The solute particle can be separated by filtration. The solute particle settle down. The particles scatter a beam of light passing through it. So it means that this property is similar like colloidal particle. These properties are different than colloidal and solution. Okay. Suspension is a heterogeneous mixture which is small particle of solid and spread throughout the liquid. You can make muddy water. Okay. This is also one activity you can do. Mix the water with mud. Then when it is a little bit not that much transparent, not that much muddy, that solution is called suspension. Solute particle can be separated by filtrate. Okay, this I will tell you with the activity. Solid particle settle down after some time. You can see this is muddy water can settle down. Solid particle scatter light as light is passing through this liquid and it is scattering. Suspension is heterogeneous fluid containing solid particle that is sufficiently large in sedimentation disintegration process we can do. So just read this slide by doing pause. And properties of suspension is particle of suspension can be seen by naked eye. Particle of suspension scatter a beam of light passing through it and make it path visible. Solid particle settle down when suspension is left behind. Okay. So dear students, when solution we studied, the solution was very clear, transparent liquid. It was not settled down, the particle light was not passing. Then colloid came. It is somewhere more, the solute is little bit bigger in size and it was showing Tyndall effect. Okay, not transparent water. Then we are not talking about suspension, is totally bigger size solute and it is showing Tyndall effect also, but those solute is settled down after some time. This is the main difference between three. But generally, for examination point of view, what are the difference between in appearance? Solution is clear and transparent, that's why homogeneous. It is cloudy and at least two substances are visible. Here it is totally cloudy but uniform and heterogeneous in mixture. Particle size is very less, 10 raised to power minus 7 to 10 raised to power minus 8 centimeter. Here it is 10 raised to power minus 3 and 10 raised to power minus 5 centimeter. Here is 10 raised to power 3 and 10 raised to power minus 7 centimeter. And now don't think here it is big, here it is small, it is small. It is minus raised to power minus 7. You know that value of minus negative, smaller the value of negative, larger the size. Okay. Effect of light of Tyndall effect. This is not showing, solution is not showing any Tyndall effect. This is showing, here also it is showing. Effect of sedimentation, there is no sedimentation. Here it is eventual settle down, it is none of the sedimentation. Visibility, yes, particular particles non-visible even under ultra microscope. Here particle is visible even the naked eye. I'm talking about the solute. Okay, here particle is visible under ultra microscope easily. So these are the basic five differences. So please learn these can come in exam. Okay, so dear students, now I'm trying to make one video related to activities, but whatever activity I told you, you have to do that activity related to colloid, activity related to suspension. It is very simple activities that you can do at home. And if you want to learn the science in best way, to do it. Okay, learning by doing is the best practice. So I will mark all those students present, or I will give them 10 upon 10, those who are going to send me those activities video, not more than 1 minute. Okay, with your own creativity. So thank you. Thanks for watching this video. Stay home, stay safe, and take care, due care of yourself, dear students, because you all are very important for us. So please take care. avoid to roam here and there, avoid to go to jungle, avoid to go to picnic spots, because still corona is there and we all are under the that I'm telling you pandemic situation of this corona. So don't ignore it, okay? Don't be corona carrier, be corona warrior. Thank you. Have a nice day.